So the very first thing you want to do to be able to go ahead and begin streaming to YouTube utilizing Streamlabs is you want to go ahead and open up your YouTube channel. Once you have your YouTube channel open, you're going to come to the top where it says a little camera icon where it says create. You're going to select that and you're going to select go live. Now, if you've never live streamed before to YouTube, once you get it authorized, it's going to take 24 hours before you can get access to a stream key that we're going to need to be able to utilize. So once you set it up today, if you've never done it before, 24 hours later, you'll get access to a stream key. So once you're here on this dashboard, you're going to come to the left-hand side where it says stream. Okay, now what you're going to see here is you're going to see a stream key. Now, it's very important that you don't share the stream key with anyone because whoever has that stream key is going to be able to stream on your behalf. So we're simply going to go ahead and select copy. And once you copy that, you're going to open up Streamlabs. On the left-hand side, you're going to come to this little gear icon, and you're going to come to where it says stream. You're going to make sure this says streaming services. Under service, you want to make sure it says YouTube RTMPS. And then here where it says server, you want to select primary YouTube ingest server. And then here, you're going to want to paste that stream key. You're then going to go ahead and hit done. That's going to go ahead and get it connected. And now we want to make sure we have the right settings set up so that way when you go live to YouTube, everything looks good. So again, you're going to select settings. You're going to come to where it says output. For output mode, you're going to want to select advanced, and then you're going to want to go ahead and follow what I have here. For encoder, you're going to want to use X264. For rate control, you're going to want to use CBR. For bit rate, you're going to want to put 9,000. Now, this is all going to be dependent on your internet speed. So you're going to want to go to speedtest.net. I'll put a link in the description of this video, and you want to focus on your upload speed. If your upload speed is above 10, then you're able to go ahead and utilize what I have here. But if it's not, you want to typically go about half of what that upload speed is, the number you want to put there, right? Then you're going to put keyframe 2, CPU usage very fast, profile high, tune 0 latency. Now, if you once you hit done and then you go live, if you have any kind of lag, I have a video on my channel showcasing you the best settings to utilize if you're having lag during your stream. But now what I want you to do is go to the description of this video and download the free guide that I created called the Ultimate Streamer Checklist. This is going to tell you everything you need to know before you go live, so that way you're prepped and know what to do, things to do during your stream so you can get people to follow you, to subscribe, so you can actually grow and build engagement, and what to do after you go live so you understand how to promote your stream and how to get people to find you when you're offline. So go in the description of this video to be able to download that free guide. Now, once you got to set everything up, you simply set go live. And that's going to go ahead and push your stream over to YouTube. Now, if you want to learn how to go ahead and add overlays to make your stream look professional on YouTube, go ahead and click this video right here where I give you free overlays that you can utilize. And I show you step by step how to set them all up inside of Streamlabs. I'll see you guys in the next video.